Hey guys, what's up? Eric Merced here, and in my last video, I went through some inking exercises that I will regularly do to warm myself up before inking either traditionally or digitally. I also spoke about how you could use those same exercises to get better at inking. If you haven't seen the video, go ahead and check out that video. I'm going to leave the link in the channel description below. So for this video, I thought of following up on the whole subject of traditional inking. And what I wanted to do with this video is basically talk about the tools that I use when I ink traditionally. So as you can see before me, I have a couple of various tools. I'm going to go through each and every one of them and explain how I use them. So let's start things off with my main tool. Every artist has his or her main tool that they use on a continual basis. For me, that would be the Pentel Pocket Brush Pen. This is a pocket brush pen that is refillable. Basically, it gives you a nice brush-like tip that can give you either thin to thick lines. It's a really awesome pen. A lot of artists use it, and you refill it easily by just opening up the barrel and inserting the cartridges right here at the end of the barrel. Now, they tend to last a pretty good long time, but your mileage may vary because it all depends on how heavily you use inks in your work. If you use a lot of blacks and you're covering them with this, you're probably going to go through a lot of cartridges. But if you use this like I do, just to do line work with this, basic line work, then you're not going to go through it as quickly as you would if you were filling large black areas. Now, the cartridges for the Pentel pen will usually come two in one package, as you can see here, and they're pretty affordable. I got this one at the local art store for like about $3.50. You can probably find them a little cheaper online, but like I say, if you're a moderate inker with the pen and you're only using the pen to do line work, these will last you quite a bit before you have to change them. My secondary main tool would have to be the Rafael Kalinske brushes. These two that I use are series 8404, and this is a number one and a number three. Now, the number one, I mainly use it exactly like I use the Pentel pocket pen. And the number three, which is a much thicker brush, I will use it for filling in large areas of black. Since it is a larger tip, I can easily use this to do line work as well, but I just tend to use two. So one for line work and the other one for filling in black areas. Moving on to my third tool of choice is this brush pen. I believe this is by Pentel. I'm not sure. There's a lot of Japanese writing here, and I don't remember when I ordered this, where I ordered it from, and what kind of branding it was. But I do believe it's Pentel branding. And it's basically just like the pocket pen, it's also a brush. Now, the difference between this one and the Pentel pocket brush pen is that you can get thicker lines with this. So I generally use this to fill in blacks when I'm using my Pentel pocket brush pen. And on occasions, if I'm using the Kalinskis, I might use this to fill in some black areas because they can cover a wide area. Now, you can also use this to ink line work and fill in blacks. I know a lot of artists that use just this pen to ink, and they do some amazing work. It's very versatile. It's very versatile. And there's a lot of artists that prefer this over the Pentel, and they even prefer this over regular traditional brushes because it's so versatile. Now, the whole barrel here is full of, well, it contains ink. And the way you use this, basically, when you're running out of ink here in the reservoir, you just basically squeeze the barrel and it'll shoot some ink in here, and you can keep inking that way. So when you're going to replace this, you just basically replace the whole barrel. That's how the refills come. Next up, there is this Copec multiliner, which is kind of new to my tools. I tend to use it for like really, really small details in where I want to have some variation in my line work. Next up is the Faber-Castell Pitt Artist Pen. This is also a brush pen, I don't really consider this like a brush pen. I consider it more like a brush marker. And the reason is because the tip is incredibly stiff. You really can't get that much of line variation. Maybe you have to break it in. I haven't broken it in. This is the 199 Faber-Castell Pitt Artist Pen, and it's also known as the Big Brush. So generally, I will use this for some type of effects or maybe to fill in a small, large black area. But I don't use this as much as I do my other tools. Next up are these Staedtler pigment liners. I have a number one here, and I believe this is a 0.5, but I have a whole set of them, and I think they go up to 0.7 if I'm not mistaken. And basically, these are just pens. You really can't get much variation in lines with these pens. So they're good for doing details, they're good for doing buildings and stuff like that where you want to keep the line consistent. That's what I use these for. If you want to do panels and comic books, these are also good for that. If you want to do anything that requires a ruler, any lines that requires rulers, these are good for those. All right, let's talk about correction. Sometimes you make mistakes when you're inking traditionally and you want to be able to correct your work. For that, I use the Deleter White number 2. This is the 30 mm bottle, and this is really good, highly recommended white paint. It's very white, it's very opaque. And it really works not only to correct your work when you make mistakes, but you can do a lot of effects, white on black effects with this paint. So again, highly recommend this. Now I got this from Jet Pens, and I need to stress that Jet Pens is not sponsoring this video, but I do want to mention them because they're really great. I love shopping at their website all the time. And I got this at Jet Pens, and you can get this at Jet Pens too, jetpens.com. They should have them there. And again, it's the Deleter White 2, and it's really great, highly recommended to correct your mistakes, but also to do some white on black effects. And finally, I want to talk about brush maintenance. Now, the Pentel Pitt pens and these brush pens that are refillable, you don't have to worry about maintenance other than just refilling them. But when it comes to the Kolinsky brushes or the Winsor brushes, one thing I gotta say about these brushes is they're pretty expensive. Now, if you're gonna invest in these Raphaels or Winsor brushes, you really want to maintain them because they're so expensive. So, what I use to maintain my brushes in top shape is this product. It's called the Master Brush Cleaner and Preserver. You can use it for wet oil paint, dry oil paint, watercolor, acrylics, and you can use them for maintaining your brushes if you use your brushes for inking, like I do. And it basically, what it does two things. It helps clean your brush when you're done with them, and it helps to maintain your brush in really top shape. So it basically conditions the brush, right, so that it will last you longer than if you wouldn't use this. So it's really simple to use. It's like this paste, and it's pretty much dry to the touch. And what you do is you wet the brush tip, and then you bring it in here, and you start working this into the brush, and then you clean the brush, and you do it a couple of times till your brush is clean. And if you want, afterwards, you can either completely rinse this off of the brush and just store your brush away, or if you want, you can leave some of this inside the brush. And what that will help do is while the brush is in storage and not in use, this will pretty much condition the bristles in the brush, and it'll pretty much keep your brush in top shape. Like I said, if you're going to invest in Winsor brushes or Kolinsky brushes or any type of expensive inking brushes, you really want to put in the effort to maintain those brushes so they can last you longer than they normally would. All right, and those are my traditional inking tools. I hope you guys have found this video educational and enjoyable. If you guys have any questions, just make sure you leave them in the comment section below, and I will try my best to answer your questions. Other than that, guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for supporting the channel. Thanks for sticking around. And I will see you guys in the next video. Until then, God bless you guys, and peace.